Alright, so nandito na tayo sa last lesson natin ngayong second grading period, which is the stoichiometry, no, or basics of stoichiometry in terms of mass, moles, and percentage composition ng isang compound. Okay, so proceed na tayo sa lesson natin. So, meron tayong mga candies na nandito, no? And then somehow, may isang bata na curious na ang isang jar ba ay o yung laman ba ng mismong jar na yon ay talagang 100 gram ba talaga or hindi, no? Kaya nagkaroon ng consciousness ba tamang term doon? Kumbaga, ano ba tawag dito? Nasa dulo na ng dila ako. Okay, yun yung parang na-curious ang bata. Parang meron siyang trust issues regarding doon sa mga candies sa isang jar na yun. So, we must weigh each candies in the small jar. The weighing scale definitely has something to do with the task, no? If we need to prepare 50 candies which are approximately 2 grams each, would it be easier to just take the mass of 50 candies? But in reality, no, natimbang natin lahat, no? And then somehow, na-observe natin sa bawat candies na naandito, according to its mass, may iba sumasakto sa 2 grams, no? May iba, may iba bumababa na 1.9, 1.8, may iba 2.1, 2.2. The mass of each candy is not exactly 2 grams, no? To prove this point, tinimbang talaga natin at ni-record natin yung result, no? Ganyan yung naging outcome. Then, we realize that the candies do not exactly weigh 2 gram each. However, we can still count the candies using their mass. All we need to do is to take the average mass of the candies by getting the total mass of the candies and divide it by the numbers of candies. So, ito na nga po yung equation na ginamit natin. Average mass is equals to total mass of the candies divided by number of candies. Ayan, dinivide na nga natin. And then somehow, pinagpa-plus-plus natin lahat ng mga number of candies with their respective weights, no? Pinagpa-plus natin hanggang sa nakabuo ng 20 gram divided by 10, no? Dinivide natin yung total mass ng candies into 20 gram, no? At dinivide natin siya into their number of candies, which is 10. So 20 divided by 10 is equals to 2 grams, no? So our average mass of each candy is 2 grams, no? And therefore, if we were packed 50 candies at a time, we need to multiply the number of candies with the average mass. So 50 times 2 is equals to 100 grams. So it means that if we weigh 100 grams of candies, that would be equal to 50 pieces of candies. And that made our job a lot easier now. Kanina, may habang tayo ay nagtitimbang ng mga candy, minsan may sumasagi sa isip natin kung kaya ba natin timbangin ng isang atom, di ba? Pero alam naman natin na sobrang malabo yung pagtitimbang natin ng atom kasi yung cell nga, hindi naman siya nakikita in 2 hours. Hindi naman talaga siya visible to our naked eye. Pan pa kaya ang mga atom, di ba? And then, dito na po tayo, no? Mag-proceed na tayo sa ating latest lesson natin, which is the atomic mass. So we can measure the atom in some other ways. The unit of mass, such as grams and kilograms, is too large for the tiny atom. Thus, the mass of atoms can be expressed in atomic mass unit or yung AMU, no, which is more convenient to use in expressing very small masses. Just like, for example, 1 AMU is equals to 1.66 times 10 to the negative 27. And then, kailangan nating timbangin dito yung as well as yung constant value ng mass ng proton at ng mass ng neutron. So yung mass ng proton is 1.007825 AMU and then mass of the neutron is 1.008665 AMU. Then consider the atomic mass ng isang helium which contains 2 protons, 2 neutrons, and 2 electrons. So ayan na nga, no? Minultiply natin yung constant value ng proton at saka ng neutron, di ba? So ayan, minultiply natin siya into 2 kasi 2 yung given natin, 2 protons at saka 2 neutrons. So, pinag-plus natin yung kanilang ang kanilang value in terms of proton at saka neutron. Then, pinag-plus natin, naging 4.03298 AMU or pwede natin siyang i-round off as 4 AMU na lamang. Ganun lamang po kasimple, no? And then, take note that the atomic mass of atom can be checked in the periodic table of elements, no? Ayan, tandaan natin. So, in terms of molecular mass, it is simply the sum of all the masses of the atoms present in the molecules of the substances. Just like the atomic mass, molecular mass is the relative mass of the carbon-12 isotope as a standard. We will present methane as an example. The relationship among atoms is, in methane, can be simplified as CH4, or yun nga, di ba? Contains 1 atom of carbon and 4 atoms ng hydrogen. So, to calculate its molecular mass, get first the atomic mass of each individual atom from the periodic table, then multiply the atomic mass to the number of each atom present in the molecule. Then lastly, calculate the sum of their products. This equation is shown in the table below. Yeah, nakita natin. Same process. And then medyo magkaiba lang siya, no? Hindi siya same process pala, I'm sorry. But magkaiba, no? So, minultiply natin yung mass ng carbon and then bumultiply natin siya sa atomic mass niya, no? So, 1 times 12.1, ayan. And then 4 times 1.008 para sa hydrogen. And then, pinag-plus natin yung 12.01 plus 4.032 is equals to 16.4 amu, which is the molecular mass ng methane. Or should we consider na 16 amu na lang, no? Depende kung gusto natin i-round off or hindi. In terms of mole concepts, no? The situation is similar to counting atoms, but the latter part is much more difficult since individual atoms cannot be counted nor weighed in the ordinary manner. To count atoms, we use a constant called Avogadro's number, which is equivalent to the mole, which is 6.02 times 10 to the positive 23. In terms of knowledge in mole concept is the key to relating mass, mole, and number of particles in elements, compounds, and chemical reactions. This is essential in chemical calculation, which is known as stoichiometry. So, just like for example, ayan, isang rib na band paper, mamaya na tayo dun. Sa isang paras ng shoes, meron tayong dalawa. Dalawang piraso. Kaya nga paras, di ba? Dalawa lang. And then, 3 na, or yung isang dosena ng itlog, which is 12, no? And then, dozen nga, di ba? And then, case of soft drinks, nabubuo siya into 16 soft drinks, di ba? And then, yung rim ng band paper, meron siyang 500 sheets. In terms of moles, no? For our purpose, no? Hindi, bago nga pala tayo mag-proceed sa mole, no? Dito nga pala, the collective counting words above, just like yung pair and dozen, pair, dozen, case, or rim, no? Are used as convenient terms for often used numbers in items in everyday life. Just as the grocery finds selling eggs by the dozen more convenient than selling them individually, the chemist finds calculations regarding the number of atoms, molecules, and ions are more convenient with moles because samples of matter typically contain so many atoms. A unit of measure called the mole has been established for use in counting atoms. So, nandito na tayo sa moles, di ba? So, for our purpose, it is most convenient to define the mole, which is abbreviated as MOL only, as the number equal to the number of carbon atoms in exactly 12 grams of pure carbon 12. A mole may be best thought of as 6.02 times 10 to the positive 23 items called Avogadro's number. One mole of something consists of 6.02 times 10 to the positive 23 units, you know, of that particular substance. Just as a dozen eggs is 12 eggs, a mole of eggs is 6.02 times 10 to the positive 23 eggs, no? So a mole contains 6.02 times 10 to the positive 23 atoms in 12 grams of a carbon 12 atoms. It is basically the mass of one mole of a substance, which is numerically equal to the atomic mass, no? Molecular mass or formula mass expressed in gram, na pwede natin tawagin sa pangalang molar mass, no? The unit used is gram per mole or g/mole. No. Example is the atomic mass of oxygen gas is 32 amu. Therefore, its molar mass is 32 grams per mole. No. So, a more concrete relationship can be established among the three important variables here, just like yung mass of a substance in grams, number of particles, at saka number of moles. So, the mole concept is a helpful way to convert one unit to another. For example, the mass of a substance in grams can be converted to the number of moles by using the periodic table of elements, no? On the other hand, the number of moles can be converted to the number of particles, no? Just like yung atoms and then molecules. Atoms or molecules, no? Using Avogadro's number, it is important to note that there is no direct conversion between the mass of a substance in grams and the number of particles. The process must go through the number of moles first before the other conversion can take place. It's like, for example, like this, a silicon chips are made up entirely of silicon, obviously, di ba? If a bunch of chips weighs 5.68 grams, how many silicon atoms are present in this chip if the average atomic mass of silicon is 28.09 amu? We need to convert the given mass to the number of particles. First, convert the mass in grams to the number of moles. The fixed relationship that can be used to convert mass to mole is the molar mass of silicon. Since the mu is numerically equal to molar mass expressed in grams, thus the molar mass of Si or U silicon is 28.09 gram per mole. Ganyan yung fixed relationship na gagawin natin. 1 mole silicon is divided to 28.09 gram silicon. Then next, multiply the ratio to the given mass of a bunch of silicon chips to cancel out the unit grams. Kinancel out na natin yung same unit, no? And cancel out the same unit, and then yan, 5.68 divided by 28.09 is equals to 0.202 mole SI. The resulting number of moles of silicon will be converted to the number of silicon atoms using Avogadro's number. So ayan. So 0.202 multiply natin sa 6.02 times 10 to the positive 23 is equals to 1.22 times 10 to the positive 23 atoms ng silicon. So next naman po, in terms of molar mass by molecules and compounds, the chalk that we used in writing for the blackboard is composed of calcium carbonate or CaCO3, no? It has the same composition of limestones, marble and seashells. If a box containing chalk has approximately 50 grams of calcium carbonate, how many formula units ng calcium carbonate are present dun sa box? First, determine the formula mass ng calcium carbonate, no? So ayan, we must find their combined mass. Yan, mumultiply natin ng mass ng given atoms na naandito, just like yung calcium, carbon, and then oxygen. So ayan. So nakita naman natin na isa lang naman ng atoms ng calcium at saka carbon, and then yung oxygen natin is ano bang tawag dito? Is tatlo. So ayan. So 1 times 40, 1 times 12.01, and then 3 times 16. So ayan. And naging combined mass, ito na yung combined mass niya. And then somehow ipag-a-add natin sila. And then pag in-add natin sila, makakabuo sila ng formula mass ng calcium carbonate with a total of 100.09 AMU. So ayan lang po. Then next po, number 2, the fixed relationship that can be used to convert mass to mole is the molar mass of calcium carbonate, no? Medyo nabubulol. Since the AMU is numerically equal to the molar mass expressed in grams, thus the molar mass of calcium carbonate is 100.09 gram per mole. In ratio, it can be expressed as 1 mole of calcium carbonate is divided into 100.09 gram calcium carbonate. So, determine, teka lang, medyo nag-skip pala tayo, no? So we must need to calculate the number of moles of calcium carbonate dun sa 50 gram sample. Saan natin nakuha yung 50 gram na sample na yun? So yun po yung given, no? Nakalimutan kong gumawa ng gresa. Kumbaga, pinapakita ko sa inyo yun, so sa inyo ngayon yung step by step process niya. So 50 gram, i-divide natin siya sa 100.09 gram na calcium carbonate. At bakit hindi natin kailangan ni multiply to dito sa 1? Actually, kahit i-multiply mo yan, ganun lang din ang magiging outcome niyan, no? And then cancel out the same unit, and then ito na ang magiging outcome niya, na 0.500 mole calcium carbonate. And then determine the formula units of calcium carbonate using the Avogadro's number. So ayan, 0.500 multiply natin sa 6.02 times 10 to the positive 23 na formula units na calcium carbonate. Ayan, cancel out the same units, and then yung ang ating answer is 3.01 times 10 to the positive 23 formula units ng calcium carbonate. And then in terms of mole and mass relationship, no, the relationship between mass, number of moles, and number of particles is essential in chemical calculations. The simplest calculation to be introduced is the mole and mole mass relationship. And then this is important in interconverting the moles of the substances to its corresponding mass and vice versa. It is wise to remember that the molar mass of the substance given to the mole to gram ratio of a substance. The formula weight of the compound is the mass of the compound. And then suddenly, this is a necessary tool in obtaining the right information in terms of mass, mole, and number of particles between the reactants and then the products in a chemical reaction. So the mole-mass relationship is essential in solving for the correct amount of substances in chemical reaction. It should be noted that in solving problems, the chemical reactions involved is a balanced chemical equation. No, pero hindi muna tayo dadaan doon sa balancing chemical equation, no, dahil pang grade 10 na yun, no. At dito muna tayo sa medyo ano muna, just a little bit easier, no. From the equation, a mole ratio is just the ratio of one material in a chemical equation to another material in the same equation. The mole ratio uses the coefficients of the materials as they appear in the balanced chemical equation. So ito po yung formula niya in terms of their general patterns. Ayan. So kapag nawawala si mass, ito yung formula na gagamitin natin or yung equation na gagamitin natin or yung pattern ng equation. And then kapag nawawala si moles, ito naman po. So yan na po, no? Sample problem number 1. What is the mass in grams of 2 moles ng iron? So itong given natin, ayan. Meron tayong 2 moles ng iron and then yung kanyang molar mass, no, is 56 gram, no? And then suddenly, ang required na hinahanap natin is yung ating equation, ayan na po, since nawawala si mass, gagamitin natin yan. And then, ang solution, papalitan natin, no, yung number of mole, which is 2 mole of iron, at saka 56 gram, which is yung kanyang molar mass. Ayan, cancel out. And answer is 112 gram of Fe. Or 112 gram ng iron. Then, next naman, how many grams of silver are in 0.0342 mole? So, ayun na po yung given natin, as well as yung kanyang molar mass na 107.9 gram. And then, yung required is mass, and then equation, ayan. Then, same pattern, replace natin yung mga given variables na nandito sa given. So, 0.0342 mole ng silver, mumultiply natin sa 107.9. So, cancel out the same unit, and then, the answer is 3.69 gram of silver. So, yun lamang po. Then, in some other cases, sa sample problem number 3, moles naman ang inahanap. No? How many moles of the beryllium are there in 16 grams of a beryllium atom? So, ayan na po, 16 gram, yung kanyang mass and substance, and then yung kanyang molar mass is 9 only. So, ang required is moles, ayan na po yung formula na gagamitin natin. Medyo kakaiba na siya. And then, yung solution, cancel out the same unit, and then 16 gram, nakalimutan kong i-cancel. Ayan na, medyo na. Ayun na, so medyo nauna lang. Cancel out the same units. And then 16 divided by 9 is 1.78 moles ng beryllium. So ayun lamang po. And then last sample problem, iron is the most important metal sa society natin ngayon. How many iron atoms are present in the piece of iron weighing 95.8 grams? So yan yung given natin. So required is moles. No, kumbaga hindi lang masyadong naging specific yung paghanap ng moles dito, no, sa sample problem natin. So same equation pa rin yung gagamitin natin. And then 95.8 gram ng iron is divided into 56 gram ng iron. So cancel out the same unit. And then 95.8 divided by 56 is equals to 1.71 moles ng iron. So ayan. I think this is the last part, no. Which is the percent composition and formulas of compounds, no. And then suddenly in this part of lesson, we are curious if without counting, how would we know how much items do we have if we both mix it together, no? Mix a particular object or material na nakita natin. So in previous lesson, we already learned how many atoms of each element are present in a compound molecule. We learned that when we added the masses of the individual elements, we could determine the mass of the compound or molecule, which we did earlier. In essence, the elements in a compound or molecule make up a fraction of the whole. So proceed na tayo dito. So this is known as mass fraction. However, to get the mass percent or percentage composition of a compound, just multiply the equation by 100%. So we will use a coffee granules to dissolve in water, no? So to illustrate our example, water contains 2 atoms of hydrogen for every atom of oxygen. We would consider the mass of each element present in water. So we need to calculate the molecular mass of water first. So yung mass ng hydrogen is 2 times 1.008 mu. No? And then yung mass ng oxygen, multiply natin yung 1 into 16 mu. So ayun na po, nakita na natin yung kanyang combined mass, and then ipagpa-plus lang natin sila. So yung formula mass ng water is 18.016 mu ng H2O or ng water. So to determine the mass percentage of hydrogen and oxygen in water, we need to consider both their masses, then divide it by the molecular mass of water and multiply it by 100%. So ayan, yung mass percent ng hydrogen, no, so 2.016 mu, no, H, no, divide muna natin sa 18.016 mu ng water, no? Then i-multiply natin sa 100% is equals to 11.2%, no? As well as ganun din yung process na gagawin natin for the mass percent ng oxygen, no? So yung mass percent ng hydrogen is 11.2%, and then yung mass percent ng oxygen is 88.8%. So take note that the mass percent of all elements present in the molecule should be equal to 100%, at kapag hindi nag-equal yan, mali kayo dyan, no? So to check, 11.2 plus 88.8%, kahit i-calculate nyo pa, lalabas din 100%. So, ganun lamang po kasimple. So we have certain rules to follow to make the calculations so easy. So here are the rules for determining the formula of a compound or molecules given its percent composition. So first, if the mass percent of each element in the compounds is given, use this as the respective mass in grams. Next, convert the mass in grams to moles using the mole concept. And then number three, divide the calculated moles to the smallest quantity to get the ratio of the elements. There is a note that there is no particular way of writing the formula of a compound or molecule. So the general practice is to write them as they are given in the problem. Now, we wanted to know that if the reverse process is possible, if the mass percent is given, would we be able to determine the formula of the compound? So malalaman natin dito. So however, the exact composition is not computed. The formula that is expressed in the smallest whole number ratio of atoms of the elements in a compound is called as empirical formula, which also means simplest formula. On the other hand, the actual formula or exact composition is given in what is called as molecular formula. So consider the glucose molecules, no, C6H12O6. The given formula is the molecular formula of the compound. Notice that the subscripts can be further simplified by dividing them by 6. The resulting formula is CH2O, which is the empirical formula ng glucose. So by doing this calculation, what is obtained is only the ratio of the elements in the compound or molecules, like the, for example, the relative number of each of the elements. So in terms of empirical formula, no, so we must first determine the empirical formula ng phosphoric acid, which is found in some soft drinks. At ito yung kanilang mga kanilang compounds, no, which contains hydrogen, phosphorus, and then oxygen, and then meron silang respective masses na naandito. I'm sorry, nakalimutan kong lagyan ng gram. And then to solve this problem, we must follow these steps. So since the given quantities are in grams and not in percentage, there is no need to convert the units, no? Convert the gram to moles using the mole concept, and then ayan na po. Ika-cancel out lang natin yung mga same units, no? Just like yung nakalimutan ko na lang lagyan ng dash. Yung gram per hydrogen at saka yung gram phosphorus, and then yung gram oxygen, i-cancel out natin yung same unit niya, and then i-multiply yung dapat i-multiply, pero mas makikita natin dito, i-divide natin yung dapat na i-divide, just like this, 0.3086 gram hydrogen divided into 1.008 gram ng hydrogen, and then yun na yung nakita natin na answer sa kanila na in terms of moles. And then the next step is to divide all the numbers by the smallest number. In this case, the smallest is 0.1020 mole ng phosphorus. So ayan na po, no? Ayan na, dinivide na natin siya into 0.1020 mole ng phosphorus, no? Kasi yun ang may pinakamaliit, di ba? Smallest number, ayan na nga po, di ba? And then, since the answer gave whole numbers, the formula of the compound must have 3 moles ng hydrogen, 1 mole ng phosphorus, and 4 moles ng oxygen, thus giving H3PO4, that is the formula for phosphoric acid. So, the empirical formula may not always give the true formula of a compound, as explained earlier, since it is just the smallest whole number ratio of the elements in a compound. So, medyo malapit tayo matapos. Sa molecular formula, on the other hand, can be computed using the equation, just like molar mass divided by empirical formula mass is equals to their whole number. For example, caffeine, which is a compound that can be found in tea and coffee, has the following mass percentage composition. Meron tayong 49.48% ng carbon, 5.191% ng hydrogen, 28.86% ng nitrogen, and 16.48% ng oxygen. So the molar mass of caffeine is approximately 194 gram per mole. So what is the molecular formula of a caffeine? So since percents are given instead of masses, we should convert first the given values into a gram. So ayan, pinalitan lang naman natin siya from percent to gram. So the next step is to convert all these masses to moles using the mole concept. So ito na po, no? Yan, dinivide lang natin, no? And then according to that, no, nakita natin yung kanilang molar masses, ayan, and then dinivide lang natin siya, and then na-convert na natin sila into a moles. The smallest value is 1.030 mole ng oxygen. Therefore, all computed moles will be divided by this number. So, ayan, cancel out, no? Cancel out the same unit, which is the mole. So, ayan na nga. So, the empirical formula ng caffeine is C4H5N2O. So, ayan. So, nagtatapos na po ba tayo? Actually, malapit na, no? Pero meron pa tayong gagawin. So, the problem, however, is asking for the molecular formula of a caffeine, and the given molar mass is 194 gram per mole. To find the molecular mass formula, calculate first the mass of the empirical formula. So, first, no, mass ng carbon, hydrogen, nitrogen, at saka oxygen i-multiply natin sa kanilang gram per mole. And then, ayun, nakita na natin, nakuha na natin yung kanilang combined mass, ipagpa-plus na natin sila para makuha natin yung empirical formula, yung mismong mass ng empirical formula na 97.10 gram per mole. And then lastly, ito na yung last step. No? Lastly na nga, may last step pa. No? So then, the given molar mass will be divided by the computed mass of empirical formula. No? So kukunin natin yung molar mass at saka empirical formula mass. No? 194 gram per mole divided into 97 gram per mole. Cancel out natin yung same unit and then, divide natin yung 194 divided by 97, magiging 2 yung kanyang answer kahit i-calculate pa po natin. So, the whole number na 2, ano yan, means that the molecular formula contains 2 empirical formula units. Thus, you should multiply the subscripts of the empirical formula to 2. No? Yan. So, 2 times 4, 8. 2 times 5, 10. 2 times 2 is 2. 2 times 2 is equals to 4. And then, 2 times 1, edito, no? Ayun, nakuha na natin yung molecular formula ng caffeine. Medyo matrabaho lang po talaga tong yung ating ginawa within this time sa lesson natin. And then dito na po nagtatapos yung ating lesson. And then kita-kits po tayo for the third grading, no? Medyo maikli lang yung lesson natin doon. And then somehow dito na po nagtatapos yung ating lesson. So, kung may mga clarifications or concerns, no? And then leave a comment below. And then that's all for today. Kita-kits sa next lesson. Goodbye.